Hello. In this course, you'll be learning about urban development from examples in many countries. But I would like to start with a brief note of caution. Cities routinely borrow models of urban development from elsewhere, but a cut-and-paste way of learning from other places has often caused more problems than it's solved. Take the case of Bangkok. For centuries, Bangkok followed a traditional model of urban development, organised around the principle of living with nature. People built their city and organised their lives around the water. From the 1960s, the city began to adopt American models of urban development and tried to control natural systems. Ancient canals were filled to make way for highways and urbanisation. This has made the regular flooding worse, and not surprisingly, it's the poorest communities that are most badly affected. I'm not arguing that learning from other countries is a bad idea. One of the best things about working here in Delft is the opportunity to share ideas with staff and students from many countries. In this course, you'll be learning with others in more than 130 countries. But we need to take care about how we capture lessons from other places and how we use examples of urban development in our own cities. The way that cities work is not like an aeroplane. We expect the physics of the aeroplane to be universal. We build it in the same way, whether it's landing in Amsterdam or Manila. That doesn't work for cities because they're rooted in a place. And places have very different geographies, economies, histories, and cultures. What works in one place may cause problems somewhere else. The current fashion for smart city solutions is a good example. For rich cities, smartness is about making use of new high-tech solutions. How relevant is this for cities where basic services don't exist or are not fairly distributed? These cities need to find their own meaning of smartness. So how can we learn from other places? Two things. First, we should try to separate the universal from the particular. That means understanding what principles can and should be applied everywhere, and what are the solutions that need to be formulated locally. Sustainable urbanisation is a good example. There are universal principles that apply in any city. For example, the need to reduce consumption of non-renewable resources. But the ways that we implement this principle needs to be decided in each city, taking account of local conditions and cultures. Second, we should be modest about our knowledge of other places. Finding a good reference project elsewhere can be very useful for experiencing other ways of looking at a problem and for generating ideas about solutions. But do you know enough about the project? Do you know enough about the place? We need to investigate the historical context and local social, economic, and cultural conditions. The problems of cut-and-paste solutions are not just abstract ideas for academics. They have real concrete impacts and consequences for communities. They should inform the ethics of planning cities, especially for those working internationally. Make the most of this opportunity of learning about rethinking the city from the examples you're shown, but concentrate on finding the principles and then work on how to apply them in your own city.